get it.
Was your sister, was your white sister in the group?
Both of them.
Was he both or?
It's got pretty big house.
Okay.
When my father died, he were, that was high school. She was half home. And she, thank you, she did, so.
Yeah.
My sister's one of them. The white sister's one of them, so she can have some place to be.
Oh, wow.
So we'll be there, thanks, we may not be able to.
Oh, you will?
Be through her. She'll have someone to go with her.
Oh, wow.
But then there's a thought, which is the stories and the childhood.
Oh, so cool.
You've heard them all, but now they're like written down. And you're praying for the sons, praying for them, you know, anyone. So we're gonna make those like every book, like give them to the kids. So that's, that'll be beautiful, a way to, that's a beautiful way to.
You're gonna get married next year, isn't it?
In summer, yeah.
It'll be here faster than you know it.
I know, and hopefully it'll be.
COVID free. Right, that's the thing.
Maybe in that one? This is nice.
I have it on my phone. I should just, if I lose it though, I'll be able to. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to Hamilton United Methodist Church Sacred Space Service, Meditative Prayer, Quiet Time, for us to be still and listen for God's voice. Let's just bow our heads and talk to God, open our hearts in a word of prayer together. Lord God, we thank you for the many blessings of this day. We thank you for the beauty of your creation. We thank you for the fellowship that we have with family, with friends. We thank you that we are still very connected in a time when we are very isolated from one another. Lord God, we're so thankful that we could gather here in our sanctuary at our home church and feel that connection and know that you are present. know that we are reaching out to one another in your love. Please, Lord God, fill us and bring us that peace and that calmness, the peace that passes all understanding, that you hold all things in your hands, even when it seems like everything is just a little out of control. We know that we can rest in you. And so that's what we're doing together in this time. Lord God, just be with us. Guide our time together. Fill our hearts as we seek to hear your still voice in the quiet. In your most precious, precious name we pray. Amen.
We get caught up in our day-to-day activities. We go from one place of chaos to the next, spinning our wheels. Let's say together, call us to the still places where we encounter you. Remind us to be still and know that you are God. Fill and renew us in your love and grace. We pray this in the name of the one who calls us to rest in him. Amen. Thank you. I'll read from Psalm 145. Feel free to speak aloud or type into the comments any word or phrase that speaks life to you. The Lord is merciful and compassionate, very patient and full of faithful love. The Lord is good to everyone and everything. God's compassion extends to all God's handiwork. All that you have made gives thanks to you, Lord. All your faithful ones bless you. Merciful, compassionate, faithful. Give thanks to you, Lord. Very patient. To all. Again, I'll read from Psalm 145. Feel free to speak aloud or type into the comments any word or phrase that speaks life to you. The Lord is trustworthy in all that he says, faithful in all that he does. The Lord is close to everyone who calls out to him sincerely, listening to their cries for help. My mouth will proclaim the Lord's praise, and every living thing will bless God's holy name forever and always. Sincerely, faithful, proclaim the Lord's praise. Forever and always. Bless God's holy name. Faithful. So we'll enter into our centering prayer time. as your thoughts drift to different places, and they will. Gently refocus and meditate on the word or the scripture and repeat it silently to yourself. A word that you've chosen. There are some examples here: forgiven, worthy, beloved, child of God, or the scripture that you'll see coming up. So don't beat yourself up when your thoughts drift away, because that's just what we do as humans, right? And we'll gently refocus and we'll meditate on a word or the scripture that you'll see on the screen and repeat it silently to yourself.
Thank you. Thank you.
At this time, all are invited to light a candle, whether you're here in the sanctuary or at the sanctity in the sanctuary of your home. If you have a candle that you would like to go and bring to your space that you're in tonight, your comfortable, safe space, if you'd like to bring a candle and light the candle as we light candles here in the sanctuary. We'll take a few moments to do that now, but first let's join in the prayer to the Holy Spirit. Let's say this together. Fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in us the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit and we shall be created, and you will renew the face of the earth. Amen. And in that spirit, let's light that candle and create that new spark. That would be the light of the Holy Spirit that we would hold within our hearts. Take a few moments now for the candle lighting.
Thank you.
open. The prayer rail is still open for anyone present who would like to come forward at any time. Please feel free to do that. We will hear the reading from Matthew. Repeated. And during the first reading, we will listen for a word or a phrase that touches our heart. Listen for what stands out for you. Jesus began to pray. I praise you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed your truth to the lowly and the ignorant, the children and the crippled, the lame and the mute. You have hidden wisdom from those who pride themselves on being so wise and so learned. The Father has handed over everything to my care. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son wishes to reveal the Father. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Put my yoke upon your shoulders. It might appear heavy at first, but it is perfectly fitted to your curves. Learn from me, for I am gentle and humble of heart. When you are yoked to me, your weary souls will find rest. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. What word or phrase stands out for you in this reading? Meditate on that in the silence. During the second reading, what do you hear? What do you see? What do you feel in these words? Let this story come alive in you. How does it relate to your own life this day? And Jesus began to pray. I praise you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed your truth to the lowly and the ignorant, the children and the crippled, the lame and the mute. You have hidden wisdom from those who pride themselves on being so wise and so learned. You did this simply because it pleased you. The Father has handed over everything to my care. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son wishes to reveal the Father. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Put my yoke upon your shoulders. It might appear heavy at first, but it is perfectly fitted to your curves. Learn from me, for I am gentle and humble of heart. When you are yoked to me, your weary souls will find rest. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. How does this relate to you in your own life today? Meditate on that in the silence. During the third reading, consider what is Christ saying to you. How is Jesus calling you forth to be renewed into doing a new thing, experiencing a new understanding or a deeper awareness? And I will read from a different translation now. And Jesus said in prayer, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Jesus says, come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. What new understanding or deeper awareness is Christ calling for you? Let's meditate on that in the silence. After this final reading, just take a moment, pause and talk with God, just as you would talk to a dear, good, dear friend, about anything and everything that's been revealed to your heart tonight. Listen for God in the silence after the final reading of Matthew 11. And Jesus prays, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, Because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. And Jesus says, come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Sit in God, in the silence of God's presence. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. To all that is chaotic in you, let there come silence. Let there be a calming of the clamoring, a stilling of the voices that have laid their claim on you, that will not let you hear your life with wholeness or feel the grace that fashioned you. Let there come an end to what diminishes and demeans. Let there be an opening into the quiet that lies beneath the chaos, where you find the peace you did not think possible and see what shimmers within the storm. And so we'll close with this beautiful, beautiful lullaby. This is a song by Fernando Ortega. It's called Jesus, King of Angels. Just let the words to the song wash over you.
Shine your face upon this house.
Go in God's peace.